Hello everyone and welcome back to our channel. My name is Ayush Kumar Singh. I am a legal intern in Lexington & Company. So in this video, we are going to discuss about doctrine of eclipse. The doctrine of eclipse means that an existing law inconsistent with the fundamental right to become inoperative from the date of commencement of the constitution is not dead altogether. It is overshadowed by the fundamental right and remain dominant but is not dead. So, what is all this doctrine about? When a court strikes a part of law, it becomes unenforceable. Hence, an eclipse is said to be cast on it. The law just becomes invalid but continues to exist. The eclipse is removed by another, that is most probably the higher level court, make the law valid again, or an amendment is brought to it by way of legislation. The Supreme Court of India in P. Ratiman case has held section 309 of IPC 1860 unconstitutional. Hence, the section was under eclipse. However, the constitutional bench in Girin Kaur case received this decision and held the section as constitutional, whereby the eclipse was removed and it became operational again. In the case held by Bombay High Court, the proceeding has been started against the appellant from an offence punishable under Section 18 of Indian Press Emergency Power Act 1934 in respect of prominent punishment in 1949. The appellant contentions was that the act was inconsistent with the fundamental right conferred by the constitution and therefore it has become void under Article 19 Clause 1 after 26 January 1950 and the proceeding against him could not be continued. The Supreme Court has held that all the laws enforced at the commencement of the constitution which are inconsistent with Part 3 of the Constitution shall be void to the extent of inconsistency. Article 13 Clause 1 has no retrospective effect but only prospective in its operation. In the case of P. Ratiman, Supreme Court held that Section 309 of IPC was unconstitutional but it was not removed from the law books and from Act. Girin Kaur case. In this case, the Supreme Court received that the judgment given in P. Ratiman case and Section 309 of IPC again come in existence, which is not removed from the Act previously but also overshadowed. So, thus the doctrine of eclipse provides from the validation of a pre-constitutional law that violates the fundamental rights under the permit that such laws are not null and void ab initio but become unenforceable only to the extent to such inconsistency with the fundamental right. If any subsequent amendment to the constitution remove the inconsistency or the conflict of the existing law with the fundamental right, then the eclipse vanish and that particular law come back again. So I hope you find the video informative. So please like, share and subscribe.